bullies. An American schoolboy comes to school seething with emotion. In the blink of an eye, several other students are either dead or seriously wounded on death's doorway. And a youngster faces a life-changing moment and perhaps the end of his days in freedom after the latest school shooting. According to early accounts, the boy was bullied. School shootings have become as common as the annual sightings of Punxsutawney Phil, the groundhog, who reportedly warns of coming cold or the thaws of spring. And whether bullying was present in this case or not, it has been a prominent feature of the recent past. Almost immediately, experts stormed the stage to decry the effects of bullying on children. Does such an attempt work? Apparently not, for school shootings have not diminished much. How could they, when American education is virtually awash in bullying? From the second Bush administration to the first Obama term, principals have been bullied by politicians. Indeed, teachers have been bullied by principals, and students have been dogged by teachers. For the law known as No Child Left Behind and its Obama derivative, Race to the Top, are instruments of state and class bullying that have absolutely nothing to do with improving education and everything to do with promoting a broken market ideology that has failed as equally on Wall Street as it has in schools. Kids are tested with a vengeance and threatened with the consequences of failure. Politicians, most who wouldn't be caught dead with their children or grandchildren in public schools, create rules that almost guarantee failure and then threaten entire communities with school closings. No Child Left Behind was a cold and cynical weapon used against poor communities. It wasn't a program. It was a bumper sticker. President Barack Obama has done little more than slap a new coat of paint on its rotting carcass. Meanwhile, countries like Finland stand at the very apex of the best schools with the best educational outcomes for students by ignoring every element of the U.S. system of educational threat and failure. They teach teachers, treat them with respect, and then teach students in buildings full of light and color. No bombast, no threats, just success. Imagine that. Teachers teaching, students learning. Imagine that. From Imprisoned Nation, this is Mumia Abu-Jamal. These commentaries are recorded by Noel Hanrahan of Prison Radio.